All right, guys, this is day one of me actually starting my album. So you're going to see every part of the process, most of the behind the scenes, except for a lot of the businessy stuff, unless it's really important. But yes, this is day one. So I'm on samplet.io. I'm using a Chrome extension called Transpose to listen to this audio in a different frame. Okay, similar to Kanye, how he would speed up records. Okay, so let's click up here. Gonna transpose this up three semitones, and it usually just gives me a brighter feeling to these records. Also, I can up the speed of the record, so let's up the BPM. Okay, so I like this vibe a lot. This is actually really dope. So I'm gonna download this and import it into FL. All right, now we're back in FL Studio. What I'm going to do is pitch this up. So let's double click, go to mode, stretch mode, and we'll deal with that later. But let's pitch this up 300 cents just so we get the same vibe. Now keep in mind, the BPM was higher too. So now I can up the BPM and listen back to it faster. So now I'm just trying to find a part that I like. I like the... Two. So now I'm counting music in my head. One, one, two, three, four, two, two, three. I'm gonna grab the slice tool, hit Shift Alt to do a vertical slice where you can nudge it around. Let's count it again real quick. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three. Four and slice. Three, four, two, two, three, four and slice. I like this, it feels very currency-like. Three, four, two, two, three, four and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three, four and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three, four and slice. Okay, this part, I don't want the whole song, but this is pretty dope. So what I would usually do is go throughout the song to find little tidbits that look cool. So I like this as a turnaround. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and slice. Two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and slice. Okay, so that's how I do my slicing. I count the music before I listen to the metronome. Also, I like this ending. Let's just slice it at the downbeat, right here. Reminds me of my Prophet 5. I mean, not my Prophet 5, what is that? Prophet 08, I meant to say. Okay, so let's grab all these pieces. So these are just chopped to the like bar count. Okay, they're not time stretched yet. So let me see. It's a lot of chops. I usually don't use this many chops. Okay, so all these need to be separated as their own audio file because right now it's just seen as one big audio file. So you click in the top left and hit U, hit enter, it's just faster. And then I'll move it down, click there, hit U, enter, move it down. That way I know which ones I made unique. So what this is doing is separating these parts of the audio from the actual song so that I can manipulate each chop as opposed to the entire song. Because if I go into the sampler right now, it thinks all these little chops are still the big song. So if I time stretch it or do anything, it's acting as if it's the whole song, which will mess up a lot of the stuff I want to do to it. Especially reverse. It will reverse the entire song and not just that small clip. Okay, so now we made everything unique. We can now do stuff to it. Okay, so what I usually do from here is... just roughly gauge. So I'll pull these back up just so you can see. Double click in here, go to stretch mode. Because this is its own thing now, I can stretch it a lot easier. So just hit the time knob until it locks to the BPM. Here's where you can turn on your metronome. And it should lock to the metronome. And keep in mind, I usually chop one bar at a time, but because we're doing this in one shot, I'm doing two bars. But real drummers do not play perfectly to a tempo like that. So it's gonna sound off in the middle, most likely. Okay, and then we grab this one. Now shortcut, hit Shift Q to lock it to the grid. So you see how this was overlapping? It was like over here somewhere. Hit Shift Q, it will lock it to the grid so you don't have to worry about overlap. Double click, go to time mode, stretch it out. And we're just gonna do the same thing for all the samples. I'll play it all the way through. Now because we time stretched first and because we changed the pitch first, we don't have to keep changing the pitch for each sample. So I'm doing the same thing, Shift Q, and I'm just time stretching each sample. I'm gonna have the metronome on to make sure everything's lined up. That's like the guitar, it's very vibey. Okay, let's grab that time knob, pull this up. And notice I'm hitting Shift Q first because we want that starting point to be on point. Because of FL Studio 21's new feature where it auto crossfades, we don't have to do like pointless crossfading. If stuff overlaps, I should say. Okay, so I'm just locking everything to a 4-bar count. Even though we counted 2 bars, it's 4 bars because we're at double tempo. So visually it's 4 bars, but technically it's 2 bars. Okay, so I'll probably morph this audio over time. So it won't just play all the way through just as is, but it sounds good as is. And the drums are light enough to where we can add our own drums without conflict. Okay, I'm hitting all the wrong buttons here. Shift Q. Again, showing you like the tedious. We have 3 more clips, time stretch. Basic. See the metronome getting a little off time because it's a real recording, real band. I'm not even sure they had click tracks back then. Okay, so stuff's time stretched. So let's say I want to take out the drums. There's no magical plugin except for RX10 that could take out the drums. I like the drums as a vibe, so I'm not going to take them out. Let's just go to the channel rack, hit control, highlight all these, hit control L, send it all to the mixer. Let's make a new channel, call it sample. Highlight all these, hit control, left click, and then right click, route to this track only. So all those samples are going to one channel where I can add different plugins. So I'm gonna add an L1 from Waves, just because the only limiter that works from Waves on this computer. I'm just gonna pull the threshold and the out ceiling down. This will get rid of the transients from the drums. You could also use a soft clipper, technically. So I'm just getting rid of the ups and downs of the drums. By compressing them. See how far I can pull this down. So it makes the sample a little bit smoother where I can add my own drums. Now let's see if I want to add some kind of quirky sound effects to this. I'm going to try out the crystallizer. Sometimes this crashes my DAW. Fair warning. Okay. So I'm trying to make it trippy. Let's do something trippy to it, like pitch it up. Let's pitch it down. Let's try both sides. 1200 cents is 1 octave, by the way. So now it has a unique vibe. Here's the effect. Let's pitch it up. Pitched up just sounds too like weaselly. I like this key. Then we can kind of push it to the background with some reverb. I like UAD's real verb. It's going to lower the long tail and lower the size here and then pull up the mix level. Okay, so this pushes the sample to the back. Something weird happened right here. Not sure what happened there with the... Gets so crazy right there. So I'm gonna take out some of that low one because it's building up pretty heavy. Okay, so I do want that kind of alien vibe. Now I'll start adding some drums. So now we have headroom. Let's figure out what some drums. So I'm gonna switch up the drums so they're not the same old drums over and over again. Let's just pick some random library. It's hard for me to see. Here's a pack called Trip Hop. Let's see if they have drums in here. Okay, let's right click. Let's open this up in Slice X. Slice X. Okay, so now these are all chopped up from a drum loop. The reason I use drum loops too is because they overlap sounds. Whereas if you just have one shots, it's just the sound by itself. But with drum loops, it'll like a real drummer is playing a ride cymbal and a kick and you hear the room. And it's a different experience than if you just played a kick drum by itself. I kind of like the loop. So let me just drag the loop in. We're just going to loop this. And the reason, because I want to keep that timing. Has a very 90s R&B feel to it. One of the kicks is a little rushed. That's all good. That might be my headset too. Let me turn it in. Now I'm just making sure the drums actually line up with the metronome. All right, so I think the issue is that the sample, because it's running through all these plugins, it gets delayed. So I'm going to take off the crystallizer for now. Kick's a little whatever. So what I'm going to do is muffle the sample. To add an EQ to take out that high end. Because that hi-hat's a little on the grid. These drums are a little slow. Sound like they're time stretched. be on auto mode, lock into the BPM. That sounds abnormal. Okay, so we need that sample to stand out a little bit more. It's a little quiet. Let's turn the output gain up. Those drums aren't as crazy as I thought they would be. I could probably just use one shots to sound cleaner. One of the snares comes in a little too early. Okay. So what I'll do with the drums is take off the EQ. All I really need is just that snare drum. Okay, so it's... And the hi-hat sounds pretty 90s. The kicks sounds 90s, but... Actually, let's see. Might just be able to draw it in. Hold up a second. Yeah, so I like that better. It's just more controlled sounding than their loop. Now we just gotta get the time right. Because we're hearing the hi-hats from the sample and that drum loop. So it's a little tricky to the ear. I also like how the sample has its own drum feel because that helps our drums. This could be the hook. Going to delay the drums as a whole, go into the cog icon, go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. We're going to drop the drums out and then bring them back. 2, 3, back. Now to make it sound more vibey, we're going to grab the drums. We're going to go to the sample bus. And what I'm going to do here is add another compressor. I like this compressor just because it's easy to set up. Pull the whole thing to the entire range. Go to Expert, External, and we're going to go to the cog icon. Actually, I forgot to do something. Go to the drums, right click, and sidechain to the sample track. We're going to go to the new compressor, go to Processing, right click, and select the drums. So every time the drums hit, they will lower the volume of the compressor, aka sidechain. Make sure these drums are going to that track though. Actually, what I want to do, let's just track, let's make that track 21 or 22, I mean, and then let's separate the kick. So basically every time the kick hits, it will lower the volume. So what you have to do is go inside of Slice X and find the kick that you used. So I use these. Marker 1 and 2. So marker 1, you need to double click on it, select the output track, and this is plus 1 from wherever the mixer is located, mixer channel. So if I have this at the 21, plus 1 means this kick now goes to 22. So I can separate the kick from the rest of the samples as the sidechain. You do the same thing for marker 2. Just output plus 1. So only the kicks will go over here to this track. And then I could sidechain the kicks to that sample group. Every time the kicks hit, they lower the volume. Gives you that push-pull effect. Let's see how else we can kind of make this sample our own. I might add some trap drums in here, just to make it different. Still think the kicks are a little early, the first kick. It's delayed a little bit more. Okay, I'm gonna set up a reverb here. It's gonna be a creative reverb where we're gonna have reverb and then delay. So let's go to, where are we at here? Let's go to Valhalla. Let's cut out some lows. We're gonna send the sample to the reverb, just left click. But then I'm gonna set up a delay after the reverb. I think this plugin, no, see, it's F2. Let's use Fruity Reverb, Fruity Delay 3, 2. Where's it at? Fruity Delay 3. Okay, so now the reverb is being delayed. Let's put it on ping pong mode. So I'll exaggerate the sample so you can hear it. Actually, I don't have to exaggerate. What I'm gonna do is just let you hear the reverb. It's getting bounced back left and right. Just gonna cut out the lows. So it keeps the track moving very subtly. I'm gonna set up a parallel for the drums. Let's add some kind of compressor over here. I like the, I forget what it's called, the IVI saturator. Send that to this chain in parallel. Same with the kicks. Just copying the value so they're equal. Adds a nice crunch to the kick. Then there's a plugin called DC1A3, which is free. Hear that crunch? Makes the drums feel like they're ripping apart. So here's without the plugin. Pretty clean. Here's with. Just adds that crunch. So I want a section where we use some trap drums. Switch it up a little bit. Probably right here. Let's do 16 bars of regular drums and then trap drums. Let's find some trap drums. Let's go to Lunch 77. Let's search chop snare. Okay, let's go here. Let's crank this up. Hit Control L, send it to the mixer. Okay, so here's where we want trap drums to come in. Hear how it's a little early, so we're gonna delay the snare. Put this time shift, so it stays in that pocket. Okay, let's find an 808 for these spins. There's like 1,000 versions of spin 808. That's overdriven. Where's the regular? Why did they make 80 versions of spins 808? There we go. So right now I'm just gonna map out the timing of the 808, not necessarily the notes, because I'm trying to get the rhythm down. I think three hits, boom, 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 is all we need for this vibe. I might speed up the tempo too. Let's pull up the tempo. I forgot we had those drums. They don't sound right at that high of a tempo. Take Control G to group these. We're gonna take out the 808 on the second half. We don't want the 808 to hit so hard all the time. Let's find a hi-hat. Right here is a little... I don't like this chop right here. Okay, let's find some hi-hats. FL just froze on me. Come on, FL, don't do it. All right, let's get out of search mode. Let's find some decent hi-hats. I like the attitude these drums have. Like if you listen to the drums, it goes, it's like a little sub under the hi-hat. So it goes like, it goes into the kick with a like that. That's what makes that unique. That's some hi-hat. Click, fill each two steps. So again, the sample isn't perfectly chopped. I mean, should I say played in time? Let's delay this hi-hat. Make it fit in the pocket. Same with the 808. Let's find that key. It shouldn't be dum dum. It should be dum. So let's change the note to Control up if you can't hear the tone of the 808. See how it's out of key? Should be dum. So I'm hitting Shift up to change the note. Then Control down to pull it back down an octave. That's all we need. Okay, so I'm gonna route this to the kick track so that every time the 808 hits, it lowers the volume. So let's send this to track 22. I forgot this is in parallel. That sounds hard though. Let's just turn it down. Also, I'm gonna fade out the 808. Part, I just don't like that part of it. That was an accident, but it sounded cool. It's gonna play a really low note. it just sounded cool when I did it by accident. Gonna layer a clap from the snare. Just copy it, Control C, Control V. So we don't have to redo all those patterns again. Same thing on pattern 4, Control C, Control V. Now you can control how much 808 goes into the distortion. I think there's a sweet spot about right there. Let's go back to the beginning. So I want to add something in here that gives us like a unique vibe. Let's try halftime. It may or may not work, but let's see. Okay, I don't think it added anything to slow it down like that. But we want to add our own touch to it. So here's where we have to start getting creative. I want to push the sample further to the back. Really, I like that guitar. I might just repeat. What I'll do is I'll save this sequence so I don't forget it. Let's clone this some type of way. Let's insert a new track. Let's just mute all these out. And then grab the pencil tool, hit control to highlight, hit shift. Left click to pull it up to duplicate, and then turn on the top row instead of the bottom row. So now I'm gonna keep this, right click, hit N to nest. Actually, right click, hit G to group. And then that will be underneath if we wanna go back to the original lineup. So I like this kind of two chop part in the beginning. Because it has that guitar pluck. Rhythm guitar. Let's mess with the pitch of this drum. I feel like it better matches. Also, I'm gonna try one thing with these kicks. I'm gonna try the Moog. Where's it at? Filter. Here we go. Just has a roll off. That sounds crazy. So a lot of the 90s stuff, they would filter out the kicks because they didn't have another way of separating the drums. So that's how you get more of that 90s vibe, is with that filtered kick. I like it here, where it's like subtly muffled. Okay, so it's just enough instruments where we can add stuff on top if we wanted to. So let's add ample sound guitar. Now here's where they have their own melody, so it gets a little chaotic. Let's just go back to the beginning for now. So I want to add like bouncy percussive stuff. Trying to think what plugin. I don't have Omnisphere anymore, so we're gonna have to settle for something different. And I don't have a MIDI controller, so it's gonna be interesting.
I'm trying to think, what can we add?
There's so many options. Let's just do the guitar for now. Switches. Okay, so this is interesting because the key switches. Okay, let's just do the long notes. I'm gonna Sasha, I gotta make this single note sound more active. Basically, the mod wheel turns on the vibrato. So you click on this plugin, go to the top left, go to browse parameters, and scroll down until you see MIDI CC number one. Let's right click, create an automation clip. Let's go to the playlist. Where is the playlist? Here it goes. Okay, so we're gonna turn this up. So basically, what we're emulating is a vibrato when somebody shakes their finger on a guitar. See how it goes like that. Now let's work on the actual guitar tone, because right now the guitar just sounds dry, which is fine, but we want to add stuff to it. So I'm going to quickly use Amplitube 5. Because it has a categories function that I like. It makes it super easy. Hopefully FL loads it up. All right, we're crunching, so let me save just in case. Let's go to browser, and let's go to genre. Let's try jazz. Yeah, I like this one, it's cool. I have some pre-save. Let me up the buffer. I think it's glitching out. All right, so sometimes my computer just goes crazy and turns my mic off. So this is probably a good point to render all this audio to save space. Especially when I record. I can't have all these plugins when I record. I like this idea. I'm probably gonna do harmonies over this type of track. To fill out the track. Let's also send this to the reverb. Let's try the parallel. Just so it has that same sizzle. Now we have our own little vibe. Still think the drums are a little rushed. There we go. I think it's because the sample has its own hi-hat. What I can do is use a multi-band to try to target that hi-hat. Let me turn off our drums for a second. Okay, so the hi-hat's from like here to here. Just want to fast release. To lower that hi-hat when it comes in. Still there pretty heavily. Okay, so we smoothed out the track and took away the hi-hats. So if you're wondering how to create your own sound, that's how you do it. It's really the effects most of the time. So here's without any effects. Here's with the effects. It has a character to it now. Let's see if we can add more bounce on the trap side. I think the sample feels different, so it feels like a whole different song. Also, I need to turn this off for that part of the song because it makes it more muffled. Up a little bit. Hi-hats can be more active. So this is a starter idea. I'm probably gonna add harmonies to the first part. Trap part I might keep. I don't know if I like it or not. We'll do like a half and half type song like Drake. So I'm going to listen to it twice through just to get the vibe. Thank you. All right, so this is a starting point. We'll see what happens when I add the vocals. The vocals is usually where I get the most creative. This is just giving me rhythm and then the general vibe. Thanks for watching. This is video one out of I don't know how many. Let's make this album together. Peace.